What if you could have one device that can predict if you're getting sick and will tell you all you need to know regarding your health, sleep, how tired or burnt out your nervous system is, as well as how much you move every day? And what if it's a ring, one and only ring that you need? That's Oura Ring. But I do actually have three of them, but more on that later. With this device, you can become a researcher of your own body and see the impact of your life's choices. And because of that, you might change your habits or even relationship with yourself. In this video, I'll share with you more about the ring, how to utilize it the best, some hidden features, what it's good for, what it's not, and more. But we are getting ahead of ourselves. Let's roll that impressive intro. By the way, what, if anything, are you using to track your life right now? Or what would you want? Okay, so what are the specs of Oura and what can it do?
Specs are infrared sensor for heart rate and respiration, 3D accelerometer, temperature sensor, 7-day battery life, and low energy Bluetooth that can be turned off and is used to send data to your phone.
Basically, it's amazing at tracking your sleep. All the best tracking is done during the night, including heart rate variability or HRV, changing your body temperature, or how often or frequently you breathe. This is derived from your HR data. This and a few more. And HRV, which are the small irregular intervals between your heartbeat, is an amazing indicator of how stressed or relaxed your nervous system is, which can determine how ready you are to perform or train, if you're getting sick, stressed, and so on. HRV is a secret statistic that will tell you so much about your body, nervous system, and so on. It's amazing. Combine it with all the other metrics and you've got an incredible device. And because Oura gathers your own personal baseline, your data and recommendations are tailored to you, not some weird average, which is great, especially if you're a superhuman or living at your peak. And of course, with the accelerometer, it can track your activities like walking, as well as how many steps you take, but also running or whatever you can think of. And with the latest update, it should also recognize when you do what. And when you're tired, you can take a moment to relax or meditate while tracking your HR or HRV to see an effect of what you do. Though, you need to stay still for this one and not move that much. And whatever you do during the day, for example, you had a late meal, you can insert it as a tag into the app, so later on you can see what effects it has on you. And the best part, you can then go back to all this data in the analytics tool to see trends and all your data. Oh, and because it's made by Finnish people, you can take it to sauna without problems, or for a swim as it's waterproof. Basically, you don't have to worry about it at all. I even use it during most of my workouts. Its form factor, the fact that it's a ring, is an advantage as well because of its tracking capabilities and accuracy. As the blood vessels on your finger are closer and larger than on your wrist, it's almost as good as a medical-grade heart rate monitor. Based on Oura research. I have the ring for 3 years now, as I pre-ordered it when it was first announced. And even though I'm on my third ring now, Oura replaced the faulty ones without any questions. I was kind of expecting that they would want it back and potentially repair it, but no. They just looked at some diagnostic data, identified that the unit has malfunctioned and sent me a new one. No questions asked. It might look like the ring gets broken a lot, so I ran a survey and watched some other reviews, and it seems like it's a relatively common occurrence, often related to battery, which is true for any battery, but because it's a smaller battery, you see the deteriorating effects way faster, so use common battery care techniques for it to last the longest. So what do you get when you buy it? As part of the package, you get a USB-C charger and a ring. I also got a sizing kit, but I believe you have to pay for this one now if you want it. Sizing kit helps as you get to try out the size even with the sensor bump, though the bump's very small anyway, but you get to wear it during the night to see the fluctuation of your finger size, so you can choose the best size for you. Though you can get your ring measurement other ways, even in jewelry store, as they have their own sizing kits. The ring is a bit chunkier than your normal ring, but for me it's not an issue at all, because of the shape of my fingers. What are some great things you can utilize Oura for? It shines when you want to see impact of different things on your sleep, from, let's say, drugs like alcohol, or routines or sleep supplements like magnesium or zinc. It gives you instant feedback as well as trending data for all your experiments. And also if you let go yourself a bit, for example by not working out regularly anymore, you'll see it in your data, which is something I can observe right now. My resting heart rate is more than 10% worse. You can also use changes in HRV to determine whether you have a hard time digesting some food, which could indicate potential allergies or that this food is not good for you. Ideally, you would want to combine this with some elimination diet to have cleaner data. For example, let's say your data are stable and you didn't eat gluten for 3 months. Then you eat a whole loaf of bread and the next day you see your HRV was lower than your baseline. That could indicate that your body has issues with what you ate. It's also a pretty good predictor to see if you're getting sick or need to rest because you are under too much stress, like me when recording these videos. With this information, you can start taking action and reduce the sick time significantly. For some tips on that, see my immunity video. However, it does not replace being mindful. You should still listen to your body, because Oura can be wrong. Instead, you should focus on your weekly or monthly trends and changes in them. But Oura, or any tracking for that matter, will help you become more mindful and create a daily or weekly habit of self-reflection when you're checking your stats and what gets measured improves. Though there's also a dark side to this, but more on that later. Oh, and with all the data that you gather now, you can geek out quite a bit. A simple level geekiness is to just use the app to see your trends and potentially observe whether some of your chosen tags have any consistent effect, for example, on your HR or HRV. A normal level geekiness is using Oura's Inside Web app. Here you can compare different data points across big date ranges or even minutes. You can compare all available data points. There's a big potential to geek out here, but if you want to be even more geeky, you can export the data and combine it with something else that you track. For example, your mood and activity tracker, and see the impact of those things. The biggest disadvantage is that tags are not shown in the web app nor in the exported data. They are just on your app. It would be great if Oura had this option, as then you could do an easier analysis of what certain tags or notes that you take in the app have on the next day. But therefore it's useful to track things outside of the Oura app so you can combine it. You can track things like what you ate, how you felt, how much energy you had, if you did any activities that bring you pleasure or satisfaction, and so on. And to not fall into a nocebo effect, more on that in a bit. So when should you not buy it? Oura doesn't actively track your HR and HRV. And as mentioned before, even with the Take Moment feature, with which you can start the tracking manually for a pretty fine period, it's only good when you are not moving. There's a reason behind this, of course, and that's the fact that any device that uses an infrared sensor, and that's all the smartwatches and bracelets out there, is very susceptible to change in the angle. Because the way they work, different angles of the sensor produce different readings. So honestly, most devices like smartwatches or bracelets on the market are not good for active tracking. Honorable exception might go to Whoop, as it uses three sensors and triangulation to mitigate this, so it does a bit of a better job for active tracking than most. Whoop isn't a subscription based, so... Oura is also not great for activity or workout tracking. It only shows you estimated hardness of your activity and burnt calories. And add to that the previous reason, you get a mediocre result. No idea about the accuracy, but as discussed before, most bracelets or watches won't really be that much better, if at all. This might have been fixed with the latest update to the Oura app, but that leads me to the next reason, and that is Android app. And that's because, historically speaking, Android app is slower to get the most recent and up-to-date features. At the time of making this video, Oura now automatically classifies your activity and tries to be more helpful by guessing whether you were running, biking, swimming, having sex, okay? Maybe not that, but I don't know because I don't have the update, nor sex. This feature is not on Android for 3 months now, and same thing happens with Take Moment feature. I was waiting for that one for 6 months, maybe more. And you can't have your ring connected to more than one device, as that can cause issues with the ring, or the battery, or the data. It's not the best tracker of sleep phases either, because it's not monitoring your brain waves. It's only guessing in which sleep phase you are in, and it's not that hard to get it wrong, because, for example, REM and deep sleep have very similar movement patterns. And the final negative point, but the one to ponder most about, you should not buy the ring if you take it too seriously. It's not always right, it doesn't always get all the right measurements. Therefore, the algorithm makes mistakes. And seeing those mistakes can activate a nocebo effect, meaning you would see a bad score, and even though you are feeling good, you would start feeling bad. It could also work the other way around, and you would start getting fitter and sleep better, because the ring would tell you you are getting great scores. There's even a controlled study that shows this phenomenon, so it's a double-edged sword. But the main message is, use the data, but don't let them become your religion. Blindly following or believing in any religion without listening to yourself is bad for you. And there goes my hidden philosophical statement of the video that you can ponder about. Anyway, as mentioned before, looking at the trends or even looking at them retrospectively and seeing what might have caused a change is still very valuable. By the way, what features do you think it's missing? Takeaways and competition. Would I get it again, even with an Android phone? Absolutely. It's the best and most convenient HRV sleep tracker out there, especially for its price. It's more designed for biohackers who are more interested in their data. And you can use the data to adjust your life, change your habits, or it might even help you become more mindful of your life and choices. But it's for everybody. However, if for whatever reason you don't get a warranty, or you are more interested in activity tracking, then I would consider the Whoop Band. It's better for athletes as it was designed for them. You won't actually own the band as it's a subscription, so it can cost you more overall. Otherwise, you can get yourself less convenient and more medical-grade devices, but it would just be more expensive. And because it would be less convenient, you are more likely to not track it all the time, and therefore you would actually miss on the longer-term trends, which is the most important part anyway. Thank you for watching. Like this video if you enjoyed it and help me and YouTube know that this video is pretty decent. Share your thoughts in the comments, even stuff that can be improved. And as I post just about once a month, subscribe and hit that bell if you don't want to miss another video where I explore different ways to live your human life at your peak. Thank you, and I love you.